Cobain was like one of the voices of our generation who just, you know, kind of saw it as it was, you know, in the same way that that Lennon or Jagger or Richards or McCartney kind of saw it in their time. These guys kind of came out and called bullshit, and Cobain was kind of on the darker side.
There was a lot of people out there that just listened to Nirvana because it sounded cool, and there's nothing wrong with that. But then there's a lot of other people out there that actually listen to the music a little deeper than that. And in our generation, there's a lot of problems out there, and a lot of people don't know how to deal with it. But he didn't offer answers. He let us know that there was somebody else out there that had the same problems that we did, that felt the same way about it. And so, a lot of the times that's better than giving us answers.
I think in the long run, what was surprising to the mainstream was how many people identified with Cobain's howl, which is as evocative of this generation as Ginsberg's howl is of the Beat.
Whatever personal problems he may have had in his life, they all came out through his music, his art, and he would explode on stage. Like, here he's smiling, but he's always aware of what he's doing. Even though he's writing on these people's hands, he's finding that chord, you know, and he's always very determined. He always has a very determined look on his face.
Punk rock should mean freedom, liking and accepting anything that you like, playing whatever you want, as sloppy as you want, as long as it's good and it has passion.
Kurt's loss is such a great loss because he, more than anyone in alternative rock, was challenging the roles of men and women, challenging sex roles, and trying to point to a vision for a new kind of equality.